Today we are going to discuss about one of the important concept in Java, which is final keyword used in Java. Final keyword used in Java. Final is a one of the important keyword that we have been used in the program itself. Okay, and how a final keyword will be reflected on Java programming, and where we have to use the keyword, and what is the purpose of that keyword, what kind of results that we are getting whenever we are using final keyword, that we are going to discuss here. Basically, sometimes we are going to restrict the users. We are going to give permission for the limited programming or limited access. I want to give permissions to a particular user in a limited basis. I don't want to give a permission, entire permission to the particular user. You want to restrict the user. Okay, sometimes. In that case, if you want to restrict the user, we are going to use different types of keywords in our Java programming. One of the important keyword is called final keyword. Okay, this final keyword will make some restriction to the user. Okay, and where we are going to implement this final keyword? The first thing is, if you want to create a constant variable, then we can use final keyword. The second thing is to prevent method overriding, then we can use final keyword. Next, third one is to prevent the main important feature of OOPs, which is inheritance. Okay, so these are the three things that we can achieve with the help of this final keyword in our Java program. To create a constant variable representing what? Okay, if you want to create a variable, you can create with the help of data type like integer x is equals to some value that we are going to assign like 10. Suppose if you want to change the variable value, you can change it at compile time, at runtime, you can change it. There is no issue at all. But if you do not want to change the one variable value, I do not want to change the variable value, then use the keyword called final in front of the variable declaration. Then that value will remains until the completion of the program. Okay, so that is the first point. Creating a constant variable, and that variable value remains same. Okay, whenever you have to use the final keyword in front of the variable declaration. The second one is to prevent the method overriding concept. Method overriding concept, in order to achieve the polymorphism, then we can use the method overriding concept. I want to prevent method overriding in my program. I won't give any permission for the accessing of methods, okay, by a class. Then in that case, you are going to prevent method overriding. Okay, so with the help of final keyword, you can prevent method overriding. That is also we'll see in practical approach. The third thing is to prevent the inheritance concept. Okay, inheritance means what? Acquiring a new properties from one class to another class. It is a mechanism that we are going to apply in order to achieve the code reusability concept. Okay, if you want to restrict the inheritance concept to a particular class, we can use a final keyword in front of the class. Then the class cannot be extended. Representing we have been restricted inheritance. Okay, so that is one of the advantage that we are having. So these are the three important rules we are going to restrict the user with the help of final keyword. Okay, let us see one by one with practical approach. The first one is creating a constant variable. For example, I'm declaring a class. The name of the class is A. On data member, I'm declaring integer x is equals to some 25. Okay, this class contain number of methods as well as the data members. For data members, I have taken integer x is equals to 25 and public static void main string args. This is the entry point of the Java programming. Our execution will begin. Now I am going to create an object for the class. We know about it. Whenever an object is created for the class, then only memory will be allocated to the class. Then only every implementation will start. Okay. So I am going to create a class object for the class A. What is the class name? A. I am creating an object called obj. We can take any name. New A. Then object is created for the class A. Now I want to change the data member value through the help of object. Object can access the properties of the class. It can access data members, it can access methods. So object have all permissions to access the data members as well as the methods. So I am going to change the value of the x. Okay, like obj.x is equals to 15. Is it possible? Possible. We can change it also. Now I am going to print this with the help of statement system dot out dot println obj dot x. Okay, then automatically obj dot x value will be printed. Whatever the value assigned from the x, that value will be printed. Initially it was 25, but after this statement x value becomes 15 because variable value is not always constant. Depends on the instruction, variable values will be varies. Okay. So that is the point. So here if you are executing this program, then what is output you will get? Obj.x value, x value will be 50. So here what you have to understand is variable value has been changed. Okay, we can change it. Okay, but I don't want to do this. I want to restrict the user. Okay, I want to make a variable value as a data member value as a constant. That is the first thing, creating a constant variable. I don't want to change the x value. So integer x is equals to 25. In front of this integer x, use this keyword. Just keyword final space integer x equals to 25. We are representing what you are making. You are making variable value x as a constant. It never changed until the program is ended. Okay. So final integer x is equals to 25 representing it is a constant variable. You will not, this values cannot change. Obj.x is equals to 50, you are representing here. Here what you are getting. If you are executing this program now, then you will get compile time error. Because of this final keyword, you are representing in front of this variable, So final integer x is equals to 25. Then this obj.x value is can't change this x value. Right? You will get compile time error. Okay, so here you are making variable value as a constant. Any variable value which contains in front of the variable declaration, it is contains final, then representing what? It is a constant variable. The value cannot change. Okay, so this is the first thing. So the final keyword restricting the user, you cannot change the value because you have used the final keyword in front of the variable. So this values cannot change. But if you are not using final keyword, the value will automatically change. You will get 50. Now if you are executing with the help of the same code, you will get compile time error. Okay, because final makes the variable value as a constant. This is our first important point. Second thing is to prevent the method overriding. Method overriding, we know about it. One method is declared in one class, the same name that we are going to use in another class, then it representing what? Method overriding. Okay, for example, I have taken a class called A. I am declaring a method here, like void display. One method I am taking here, SOP system.out.println. So I am writing some statement like base class. One method I am declaring in this class. Okay. Now I am taking another class. Class B extends A representing inheritance. So inheritance means Now P becomes children, A becomes class. So P can acquire the properties of the A class. It contains only one method, display. So P can access display method. Obviously, we are talking about parallel overriding. So two classes has to use same class, same method. Here also I am using void display. Void display. Some SOP. Derived class. Right, we know about this. Okay, now here only I can write public static void main string args. Now I am going to create object for which class? Which is already extended, class B extends A. So I am going to create object for the B only. So B obj which is equals to new B, object is created for the B class. So B can, this obj can acquire, then it can uses the member functions of A class as well as the B class. Okay, now I'm going to call obj.display. obj.display, here the display method is available in both classes, in B as well as A, which is going to be executed. It is always giving preference to the derived class only, so you will get the output as derived class. Whenever you are executing the same code, you will get the output as a derived class. It will give the first preference to the derived class only. You will get the derived class. Here what you have to understand is the classes A and B uses the same name of the method. Here void display, here also void display. Then it can represent a method overriding. Right? Our concept is how to prevent method overriding. Representing what I want to, I do not want to apply. I want to restrict the user to prevent method override. Then what is the solution? Just use funnel keyword in front of the base class method. Just use funnel keyword in front of the base class method. Final void display. Previously you have eliminated funnel keyword, and if you are executing that, you will get the output as derived class. But if you are placing funnel keyword in front of the base class method, then method overriding is not possible. You will get compiled error. Method overriding is not possible because a method, it is finalized here. A method is finally, final method is, okay, this method contains final keyword. Representing it is a final method. So final method cannot be overridden. That is the point over here. So how to prevent method overriding means we are going to make this method as a final. Then this method cannot be override. Normal method overriding is possible, but if you are representing this method as a final, then this method cannot be override. So it is called, it is going to be preventing the method overriding with the help of final keyword. Okay, this is the second option. Next, third one is how to prevent inheritance. How to prevent inheritance. Okay. So I am going to, how to prevent inheritance. Inheritance means acquiring the properties of from one class to another class. For example, here I am declaring one of the class called A, class A. One method I am declaring void display SOP base. So one method I am defining in one class. I am taking class B, extends A. Extends A representing what? Extend is a keyword that we can apply inheritance concept. Okay, so B can acquire the properties of the A. So B can use this void display. Obviously, we can use this. So public static void main string args, entry point of the Java program, and create, I'm creating object for B class because B is a derived class. It can acquire the properties of the base class. That's why I'm creating object for the B class only. B obj which is equals to new ob new B. Then object is created. Next I'm going to access obj dot display. This object can acquire the properties of the base class obviously. If you are executing this, you will get the output as base. Inheritance we have been applied. Single inheritance we have been applied. Okay, one parent class is there, one children class is there, children class extending A, representing inheritance. So class B can acquire the properties of class A. If I am executing this, I am creating object for the B class and the B object is accessing A method. Is it possible? Definitely. This is nothing but inheritance, which is a single inheritance. But what is our concept? I want to prevent inheritance. I want to restrict the user. Okay. You do not want to apply inheritance concept. Okay. For my program. In that case, how do we restrict the user? Very simple. May one particular class, base class as a final. Final class A. Then it becomes final class. Final class cannot. For final class, we cannot apply inheritance. For final class, we cannot apply inheritance. It cannot be extended. It cannot be extended. So, this particular class cannot be extended. So, here, if you are executing this code, previously, if you are avoiding final, you will get the output as base only. But I am making this class as a final, then this final class cannot be extended. Then, what will be the output? You will get compiled and error. Because we are restricting the inheritance. So these are the three things that we can achieve through the help of final keyword. If you want to make a variable as a constant, you can make it with the help of final variable. Second one, if you want to prevent method overriding, then you can do that with the help of final keyword. If you want to prevent inheritance, that is also the possible. So these are the three things which are applicable to the users, which are some restrictions that we can apply along with the keyword called final. Okay, thank you.